As iPhone 12 is available on the market, the price of iPhone 11 dropped significantly. And after the release of iPhone 12, a lot of my subscribers are asking me that should we buy the iPhone 11 instead of the iPhone 12, as it is much cheaper, $599 from Apple. And if we buy it from some third-party website like from eBay or Amazon, we may get it for much cheaper price, or there are a lot of deals going on over the iPhone 11. So should you get the iPhone 11? My straight answer to them is, nope, you should not buy the iPhone 11. From my query, I found 17 things those are deal breaking. You are going to get 17 more things with the iPhone 12. You won't get this thing on the iPhone 11, and just for very minimal price, you will get all of these 17 amazing features that you will enjoy, and you will feel that I would miss a lot if I did bought the iPhone 11. And that's why I tell my subscribers to save some money and go for the iPhone 12 instead of the iPhone 11. Yes, I know that the iPhone 11 is amazing product, but the thing is, while iPhone 12 is available on the market, we won't consider the iPhone 11 because we have a better thing to choose, and that's the basic reason why we'll not choose the iPhone 11 instead of the iPhone 12. Okay, there are 17 things I have noted down over here, and let's talk about every feature that I have noted down. And I think all of these 17 features, I mean, after hearing all of these 17 features, you will definitely think that the iPhone 11 doesn't owe that price. The iPhone 12 is much way better product than the iPhone 11. Okay, let's start with the display factor. And I'm assuring you that after hearing the display factor only, you will feel that the iPhone 12 is much better and much worthy device than the iPhone 11. Okay, there are 5 things on the display sector that is better on the iPhone 12. Let's go with the number 1. That is, you will get Super Retina XDR, basically OLED display on the iPhone 12, whereas on the iPhone 11, you will get a normal LCD display. That's not OLED, and OLED is much much better and preferable than the LCD display. Number 2 is HDR support. You will get high dynamic range support on the iPhone 12. You won't get that high dynamic range support on the iPhone 11. The next feature is very very interesting, that is contrast ratio. On the iPhone 11, you will get 1400:1 contrast ratio, whereas on the iPhone 12, you will get 2,000,000:1 contrast ratio. 2,000,000 versus 1400. Can you understand the display factor, the color contrast ratio? One, the iPhone 11, that is 1400. Again, the competitor iPhone 12 is 2,000,000. Where is the competition? No competition. 1400 versus 2,000,000. Where is the competition? I don't see the competition. The next one is pixel per inch. Where on the iPhone 11 you get 326 pixel per inch, on the other hand, on the iPhone 12 you will get 460 pixel per inch. And I think you already know what is pixel per inch. If you already know what is pixel per inch, then you won't consider the iPhone 11. 326 is way less in 2020. Okay, the 460 is much crispier, much better, especially with that OLED display technology. The next feature, display feature, we'll get with the iPhone 12 is brightness. We can get up to 1200 nits of peak brightness on the iPhone 12, whereas on the iPhone 11, we don't get that. Yes, I know that the normal brightness is same on both devices. Even after that, the peak brightness is better on the iPhone 12. The peak brightness means if you are watching Dolby Vision movies, you are watching some HDR contents, then you will feel that the brightness on the iPhone 12 is much brighter than the iPhone 11, and that's the thing you should consider before buying the iPhone 11. Before wasting your $599, you should definitely go for the iPhone 12, man. It's really great. Okay, so these were the display factor, and I think you have already heard all of the display factor. And after hearing all of the display factor, I think from my personal heart saying that you won't consider the iPhone 11. Okay, the next things are the basic things that we get with every iPhones. Okay, the first one is the weight. If you don't like heavy phone, then the iPhone 12 is better. It was a little shocking factor for me that why the iPhone 12 is a little lighter than the iPhone 11. Then I researched a little bit and I found that because of the phone is boxier and they don't need to round a shape, it has little thin bezels. That's the reason the phone is not that heavy as the iPhone 11. The iPhone 11 is 194 grams, whereas the iPhone 12 is 164 grams. The next is IP rating. Yes, the both devices have IP68 rating. IP68 water rating, but on the iPhone 11 you get only up to 2 meters. On the iPhone 12 you get up to 6 meters, and that's a very big deal breaking for some people's. Maybe I personally don't think it's a very big deal breaking. The next one is the processor. I think you already know that the iPhone 11 has A13, the iPhone 12 has A14 processor, and the iPhone 12's A14 processor is much better than the iPhone 11. The iPhone 11 has 7 nanometer processor, the iPhone 12 has 5 nanometer processor, the fastest mobile processing chip on the market with 5 nanometer technology on the market. That's for the first time. Apple is the first brand to introduce 5nm chipset on their iPhone 12 series, and I think it's a very big deal breaking. If you are playing games, then you should definitely go with iPhone 12 instead of the 11. Anyway, the next one is 5G. Yes, I know that 5G is not a big deal breaking for most people, because for most people the 5G is still yet not available on their location maybe, and that's the reason 5G is not a very big deal breaking thing. But yes, that's the thing you should consider if you want to use your phone for a long period of time. The iPhone 12 is better, but my personal opinion is 5G is not a very needy thing for me or right now. Most of the time, if you are in USA, if you are living in USA or country like those, then you may consider the 5G, but otherwise I don't feel that 5G is very necessary feature. Anyway, the next feature is MagSafe. The thing is, you can use the MagSafe charger on any iPhone basically, but the thing is, the magnetic connection is only available on the iPhone 12 or higher than that series, so you won't get the futuristic vibe of Apple iPhones basically. Yeah, so on the iPhone 12, iPhone 12 Pro, iPhone 12 mini, or on the iPhone 12 Pro Max, you'll get the magnetic MagSafe connectors available, but on older device like the iPhone 11, you won't get that thing. So I think in future Apple is going to introduce that there will be no port needed for the connection with the computer and the iPhone. And if you buy the iPhone 11 this time, then you may miss some features. I'm not sure, but from my personal feeling, I think so you may miss something. And that's why I'll be on the safe zone with the iPhone 12 with the MagSafe features. Anyway, the next feature is again on the display, but it's a hard material thing. That is, the iPhone 11 has Gorilla Glass. On the other hand, on the iPhone 12, you'll get Ceramic Shield display. And Apple is claiming that the Ceramic Shield display is 4 times harder to break than the iPhone 11 display or the iPhone 11 Pro Max display, because those are using the Gorilla Glass. This time, they are also partnering with Corning, but they are using the latest technology, that is Ceramic Shield. I think it's like a combination of ceramic and glass, but the thing is, glass is glass and glass breaks. So I'm not super confident. Let's see all of the drop test, bend test coming on YouTube very soon. Not on my channel, because I'm not super rich to break iPhones. So that is the thing you should consider. The iPhone 12 has Ceramic Shield display. On the other hand, the 11 has only Gorilla Glass display. That's the thing you should consider definitely. Okay, those were about the basic things. Now let's come to the camera feature. And in the camera sector, you'll get a lot of improvements that you won't want to miss right now in 2020. Okay, let's start with number one thing that no YouTuber mentioned right now, that, well, like, they were talking about the devices, but I haven't seen any YouTuber talking about the wide lens. I mean the primary lens, that iPhone 12 has 1.6 aperture, whereas on the iPhone 11 you have 1.8 aperture. On the iPhone 11 Pro Max there are also 1.8. that means the aperture on the iPhone 12 is much better. Eventually that means your device can capture better night mode photos because of that bigger aperture. F1.6 is much bigger than the F1.8, and that's the reason your iPhone 12 can shoot much better low light photo comparing to the iPhone 11, and that's a very big factor you should consider. Anyway, the next one is Smart HDR3. On the iPhone 12, you'll get Smart HDR3. On the other hand, on the iPhone 11, you won't get the Smart HDR3. You will get only the next generation of Smart HDR, not the Smart HDR3. You may ask me, what is the Smart HDR3? The thing is, the Smart HDR is much more powerful than before. It can indicate your face, your body, and it can differentiate you from the background, and that's the reason it can better expose you, better color correct you, better saturate and better contrast you, and that's the reason you will get much better photos even on dark, even on shadow, even on dark night. Yeah, that's a very welcome feature on the iPhone 12, and that is the thing you will not get on the iPhone 11. Anyway, let's go to the next one, that is HDR Dolby video recording. Yes, you heard it right. You'll get HDR Dolby Vision video recording on the iPhone 12. You won't get this on the iPhone 11. If you are a video shooting guy, the iPhone 12 is like 100% recommended than the iPhone 11. The thing is, HDR Dolby Atmos recording is only available to those very expensive cameras. Like, those cameras will cost you more than $5,000. And you're getting that same feature on the iPhone 12. You can imagine the thing, like, I can't think, like, how powerful Apple's processing system and image signal processor is going on. The next one is night mode time-lapse. You can shoot night mode time-lapse with iPhone 12. You can't do that on the iPhone 11. It's a basic small thing. It's not necessary for everyone who is vlogger, especially. It's necessary from them. You can see Neustadt. It's for you, not for me and other people like that. Anyway, the next feature you will get is night mode selfies. On the iPhone 11, you will not get the night mode selfies. But on the iPhone 12, you will get night mode selfies. That means you can basically shoot night mode photos with the front camera at night. That means night mode selfies, that's a new feature. Anyway, it's a new feature. Eventually, the thing is, on the iPhone 11 you don't have that, on the iPhone 12 you have that thing, so you should consider that thing as well. The next one is the diffusion. You get the diffusion on the iPhone 12, not on the iPhone 11, because it was a pro feature that was introduced with the iPhone 11 Pro Max or the iPhone 11 Pros. But right now you can get the same feature, diffusion, on the iPhone 12. And you may consider that, why diffusion is not that important? But my friend, you are wrong. Diffusion is pretty important thing. Like, you are watching this video, if this video had diffusion technology, then you would be able to see my beard much more better, my hair much more better. But if you don't have this technology diffusion, you won't be able to see my hair and my beard that well. And that is the thing you should also consider, especially when it is nighttime. Like, in my room I have very good lighting, but if you don't have this amount of lighting, then this diffusion will help you much more than in daylight. The thing is, if you haven't understood anything, any little bit of thing on my video, then you should definitely go and check the description. Everything I've talked about in this video is also available on the description. You can read them from that place and you can get better understanding, and you can also compare which one should you get. And my final opinion is, don't buy the iPhone 11 right now, because the iPhone 12 is a better deal. When we have a better deal, why we should go to the backward? I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Be sure to subscribe, be sure to press the bell icon. I think that you'll enjoy all of the videos. If you enjoy, again, share this video with your friend or other videos with your friend. Anyway, that's all. Bye.